Hello guys and welcome back to another episode of Chernobyl Chronicles. I read about online and apparently I failed the teleport thing that supposedly it's over there on the freaking anomaly field. So I need to try that again, really. So let's try that again, shall we? This is going to probably take a while. I'm really sorry. I'm a noob at this, I know. I'm not unarmed. Yeah, just okay, get that, please. Okay. Generated some health back, which is good. And I want to avoid this. Thank you. And we should be more or less on the stage, hopefully. It's over here somewhere, so I seem to die a lot. Don't worry, everything's been planned. Or not. Nope, not that way, obviously. There's a freaking artifact somewhere here. Okay. I'm ready. I'm ready, almighty teleport. Please teleport me. No. Come on, it's gotta be around here somewhere. I really don't want to feel like doing everything again. Really? Game, please? There we go. And there's a pseudo-giant, obviously. So let's hide from it. Turn off the light. Turn on the light, because I can't see crap. And there we go again. Well, this is being fun, isn't it? And we're almost there, apparently. Well, I can say that it's not been that easy. Pretty sure that there's a better way to get to this place. Which I'm pretty sure I could gotten to it, and at least I'm not dying of radiation, and I should save all my things back in Pripyat. Now I'm all out of weapons and equipment and all that stuff, and there we go. Well, that went better than expected, I guess. Okay, here we go. The outcome. Okay, we talk to Gabara, which is not this guy. Obviously, those are the freaking monolith people. I'm going to turn off everything, really, because I don't want to be spotted, as I have nothing on me, really. I do have a weapons, but they're not that big of a deal, really. So instead of going to talk to Gavara, I think I'm going back. Actually, he's right here, I might as well just go talk to him, really. Something is happening, though. And I'm dead. I almost forget that this kills you almost instantly. So let's try that again, shall we? I should go get more equipment, really. So I'm not equipped whatsoever for probably what's coming next. At least I'm not dead. And there were so many artifacts that I caught. Oh, I got screwed, really. I should have gone and saved them. No! No way I'm dealing with you. Screw you. Screw you. Big time. Oh, please, just chill with all the mutants. Okay, can we please get the hell out of here? Please. Just going to quick save before I talk to him. So what now? Okay, let's get the hell out of here. Apparently there's friendlies outside. Oh, I'll take that, thank you. Oh my god, really? And I stopped to loot that guy. That was really, really smart. Sorry, Guevara. Oh wow. This is turning out to be great. Oh, please, no. Save again. Oh, crap goes south again. No, I'm not staying with you. Come on. Come on, Guevara. Bring those pieces. And welcome back. I'm really sorry, but this is being a really, really mess thanks to those freaking snorks. I had literally to restart the game. Okay, so that's not to worry about. I'm going to avoid these things to my best extent before I can go to the second floor, obviously. Try to deal with that guy. all of that. Load, drop. We have some minor radiation poisoning, which is not that bad. Let's try now. Hopefully those things are long gone. So be it. Okay. О, вау!
С тех пор, как Климские Лары покинули зону, прошло уже почти 5 лет. К великому сожалению, Скиф не смог выбраться в живой из этой чертовщины. Друзья помнят о нем и по сей день. Жаль его. Хороший он был человек и поступил как герой. Та загадка, из-за которой Клим пришел в зону, почти прояснилась. Барлонда мертв. Крюк, насколько известно, покинул зону. А Тор по-прежнему рулит ненавидим. Но некоторые вещи до сих пор не знают Клима и остаются до конца неясными. Бывает, он просыпается ночью и слышит далекий голос, зовущий его к себе и обещающий ему обрести то, что он заслуживает. Нечто подобное Клим слышал еще тогда, в Припяти, когда взял в руки тот чертов артефакт. Иногда у него даже возникает сильное желание вновь пересечь периметр и вернуться обратно. Зачем? Он и сам не знает ответ на этот вопрос. Не зря, говорят сталкеры, зона просто так не отпускает. До сих пор осталось непонятным и то, каким образом все эти подземки вышли из-под контроля госбезопасности. Такой огромный комплекс лабораторий, о происходящем в них смогли узнать только после второй катастрофы. Странно все это. На этом записи Клима, названные хроники Чернобыля, заканчивались. И хотя в дневнике еще остались чистые страницы, никто, даже он сам, не знал, будут ли они в дальнейшем
заполнены. And that's it. And that's the end of it. Well, it was quite unexpected, really. I don't know if I actually missed some quest that Clemmy could give me an alternate, an alternative ending, but this is it. This is the end. Clem has left the zone. So, I hope you guys have enjoyed this episode, have enjoyed the series. A really good mod by the In Spite of the Death team, the creators of SGM3, which we haven't seen yet. Hopefully very soon. Thanks again for your support and watching, and I'll see you guys in another adventure. Bye!